Hey everyone and welcome back to Daily Tuition. In this video, we are going to learn how I set up a VS Code theme for all my projects, so the VS Code looks more prettier and professional. So let's see how to do it. You have to first open your browser and search for VS Code and then click on this first website. So you have to download the installer. So I'm going to click on this button and download this VS Code. You have to just follow the on-screen instruction. The installation process is straightforward and shouldn't take long. So once you've done that, the VS Studio Code something look like this. What I have to do is, I have to just zoom this little bit up so we'll see everything more clearly, and I'm going to customize the setting.js file of the user. So first, I have to change the theme. So I'm going to click on the setting icon, click on these themes, and then choose the color theme. And from here, I'm going to choose this dark theme. Just click on it. This will change the color of this theme. Just out of that, I'm going to click on this Explorer tab, and here you can see, you can open a new folder and start creating your project. But before that, I have to change this appearance of this VS Code. When you press Ctrl+Shift+P, this will open this window. And from here, you have to change the user setting of setting.js file. So you can notice here we have open user setting. After this default dark, pass here a comma and then press enter. I want to first increase the editor font size. So in the double quote here, I say editor.font size. And I'm going to choose 16 here. When I press Ctrl S and save this, you can see the size of this font is increased. And then I'm going to zoom this window a little bit. So in the double quote, I'm going to specify window dot zoom level. And this is going to be 2. When I save this, you can see this will zoom this VS Code and you can see everything more clearly. Now, just out of that, let me set up the font family. So here I'm going to say editor dot font family. And instead of this default font family, let me change this to Fine Sans Mono. Make sure you have this font family installed in your system. Otherwise, you won't get any effect on your VS Code. I already have this, so I'm going to save the changes. And you can see, we have this font family to this text. I'm going to add here editor.fontWidth. And the font width is going to be 400. If I open the terminal, I wanted to increase the size of this text as well. So I'm going to say here double quote and then specify here terminal.integrated.font size. And this is going to be 16. So this will increase the font size of this terminal. Just out of that, I also want to specify this font family to this terminal. So I'm going to pass here a comma, copy this, paste it here. Instead of font size, now I'm going to say font family. And I'm going to copy this and paste it down here. Save the changes. I'm going to have the same font family to this text as well. Now, just out of that, I want some custom color to this theme. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to first select the workbench, then select the color customization option. And here, inside these curl braces, I can select my theme. So this is going to be the default dark theme, this one. And to this default dark theme, I'm going to specify my custom colors. So here I'm going to say sidebar background. And I'm going to choose my own color here and specify that to this sidebar background, just like this. When I save it, you can see I'm going to have my custom color to this sidebar. Just out of that, if I want, I can say here activity bar background. And I can specify my own color to this setting as well, just like this. So I'm going to have the same color to this activity bar. Just after that, here I'm going to specify editor background and terminal background color. So I'm just going to copy and paste that setting here. You can see I have this color to this background. Now if you want, you can change this editor and this terminal background color according to your need. You can specify your own styling to this VS Code. That's upon you. Just out of that, I'm going to save these changes, close this setting.js file, and then I'm going to open this extensions tab. Right here, you can find extension. Extension actually add more functionality to the VS Code. So when you click on extension, you will have most of the popular extensions here. I'm going to install some popular VS Code extension. I'm going to install Python. Then install this live server. This prettier. To format the code, and then you have a bunch of extensions to your VS Code. You can install these according to your need. Just for now, I'm going to leave everything as it is and open the empty folder and start creating a new project. So see you soon in the project.